Hi everyone. In the last ABAP series TechBytes video, Shilpa had taken us through the overview of ABAP series. In today's video, we'll be discussing about virtual elements in CDS. Have you ever run into a scenario where requirements placed on a CDS data model are very difficult or impossible to meet with basic CDS functionality? Take for example performing complex calculations like calling function modules to determine field values, or let's say mapping a recursive logic using data from other systems. This is exactly where virtual elements comes into picture. Virtual elements are used if you want to include elements in your CDS data model that are not available in the persistence data model of the database, but are calculated using complex ABAP program logic. The calculation is performed in the ABAP classes that implement interfaces provided for this purpose. The virtual elements are calculated on the ABAP application server or the ABAP platform. Please note that you can use virtual elements only in CDS projection views. The ABAP implementation class is referenced by annotating the virtual element in the CDS projection view with the syntax object model virtual element calculated by followed by the ABAP class name. Here the values of the virtual elements are calculated in this ABAP code exit class. By using a virtual element in a CDS projection view, you define an additional field for your OData service. As this additional field is not persisted in the database layer, its value must be calculated during runtime. As mentioned before, the calculation is implemented in an ABAP class that is referenced in an annotation on the virtual element in the CDS projection view. Let us quickly check the procedure. First, the calculation class must implement the interface if saddle exit calc element read. This interface provides two methods for the calculation implementation. First method is getCalculationInfo, which is a method called before the actual data retrieval. It ensures that all the relevant elements that are needed for the calculation of the virtual element are selected. Second is the calculate method, which is called after the data retrieval. It uses the values of the relevant elements to calculate the value for the virtual element. Here is an example code snippet of the ABAP code exit class. In addition, there are two other interfaces, if saddle exit filter transform and if saddle exit sort transform, to define and implement filter and sort transformations. Please note that the OData service metadata do not differentiate between regular CDS elements with database persistence and virtual elements, which means the virtual element appears in an application UI similar to any other element. Now let's quickly check a demo that explains how to use virtual elements in CDS projection views. Here, we will create a new field within the flight booking view of the travel app that calculates how many days are left from today until the date of the flight. So let's get into the system. So for demo, let us go to the projection view for booking. Here we'll be adding a new field, remaining days to flight, with the keyword virtual to denote that it's a virtual element. The label is remaining days to flight. And here you can see that I've already mentioned the ABAP code exit class where the actual calculation of virtual elements will happen. I've already created this ABAP code exit class due to time constraints, but let's check the code in detail. So as a first step, let's define the interface if a saddle exit calc element read. This interface contains all the relevant methods that are required to calculate the virtual elements. We've also defined a method calculate days to flight, where the actual logic to calculate the virtual elements will be written. Inside the class implementation, you can see that we have used two methods, one calculate and the next one is getCalculationInfo. The getCalculationInfo method gets called even before data retrieval because it can collect the values of all the fields that are required to calculate the virtual element. So here in this case, we are trying to calculate the value of remaining days till flight field. And for this, we require the value of flight date field. So after collecting this value, the result is sent back to the calculate method. Inside the calculate method, it is using this value and calling the method calculate days to flight. Finally, in the calculate days to flight method, it is subtracting today's date from the flight date to get the result, which is the remaining number of days for the flight. So after the coding is complete, the last step is to test the application. So for that, go to the service binding and preview the travel app. So the travel app opens up and let's see how many entries are there. Select one entry and go to the booking view. So here you cannot see the remaining days to flight because we have not added it to the view. Let's go to the settings and select the remaining days to flight column and click on OK. So a new column gets added to the booking view called remaining days to flight, and it contains a value 223, which is nothing but the number of days from today to the flight date, which is on Jan 29th. Okay, so this is a very simple example that we have used to illustrate the usage of virtual elements. According to your business scenarios, it can be a complex use case also. So do try it out and let us know in case you have any questions in the comment box below. We'll be back very soon with a next episode of SAP Tech Bytes on ABAP CDS. Till then, take care and happy learning.